Hello, welcome to Bite Size Med. This video is on the structure of skeletal muscles. Humans have three types of muscle tissue: skeletal, smooth, and cardiac muscles. Smooth muscles are in the walls of hollow viscera, like the digestive tract and blood vessels. Cardiac muscle is specific to the heart. But skeletal muscles are those that attach to the skeleton, so to bones, like the biceps, triceps, quadriceps, and the hamstring muscles. And in this video, we're going to look at the structure of a skeletal muscle. Like I said, skeletal muscles attach to bones, and they do that via tendons. The surface of muscle is covered with connective tissue, which is continuous with that over the tendons. This is the outermost connective tissue layer, and it's called the epimysium. If we look at a cross-section of a muscle, it's made up of these fascicles, which are basically bundles of muscle fibers. The epimysium forms thinner connective tissue between the fascicles, and this is called the perimysium. So the fascicles are surrounded by the perimysium. The fascicles are bundles of muscle fibers, and the connective tissue around each fiber is called the endomysium. Muscle fibers are actually skeletal muscle cells. These cells are cylindrical, and they've got multiple nuclei at the periphery. Each fiber is made up of myofibrils. The myofibrils have alternating dark and light bands, making them, and so the muscle fibers as well, striated. So skeletal muscles are striated muscles. What's responsible for these cross striations? The myofilaments. The myofibrils consist of thick and thin filaments. Now let's put it all together. So skeletal muscles are made up of fascicles, which are bundles of muscle fibers. The muscle fibers are made up of myofibrils, and the myofibrils consist of thick and thin filaments, which are myofilaments. The muscle itself is surrounded by the epimysium, the fascicles by the perimysium, and the muscle fibers by the endomysium. Epimysium is the outermost, and the endomysium is the innermost layer. The connective tissue layers have got the vascular and neural supply to the muscle. Now let's look at a muscle fiber. It's a muscle cell, so it's got a cell membrane and a cytoplasm, but the membrane is called the sarcolemma, and the cytoplasm is called the sarcoplasm, so they've got special names for these two. The sarcoplasm has the myofibrils, and they are made up of myofilaments. The myofilaments are the ones that are responsible for the alternating dark and light bands. The dark bands are called A bands, and the light ones are the I bands. The A bands are anisotropic to polarized light. That's what makes them dark. A is for anisotropic, while the I bands are isotropic to polarized light, and that's what makes them light. That's why they get those letters. The I band is divided by these lines or discs called the Z lines or the Z lines or the Z discs. What forms these bands can be seen on electron microscopy. Thick and thin filaments that are responsible for the striations. The thick filaments are made up of myosin, and the thin filaments have actin along with tropomyosin and troponin. They interdigitate, so they alternate one after the other. The portion with just myosin forms the dark A band, while the sides with the thin filaments, they form the I band. The thin filaments attach to the Z disc, so that's the dark line in the center of the I band. The region between two Z discs, that forms a sarcomere, and this is the unit of contraction for a skeletal muscle. The sarcomeres repeat one after the other along the length of a myofibril, and when the sarcomere shortens, that results in a muscle contraction. The shortening happens with the movement of the thin filaments. The thick filaments stay in place, they don't move. So when the sarcomere shortens, the A band doesn't change in dimensions, but the I band shortens, and the Z discs move closer together. In the center of the A band, there is a pale H zone. This is where the filaments don't overlap. The myosin molecules that form the thick filaments, they've got their tails in the center and heads that angle outwards. They are arranged in an anti-parallel direction so that the myosin tails attach to the center, creating the M line. So that's the dark line at the center of the H zone. Again, when the sarcomere shortens during muscle contraction, the M line obviously will not change its position, but the H zone reduces in size. So we've got A bands, I bands, Z lines or Z lines, the H zone, and the M line. Those are the cross striations. So these are the myofilaments, and they were inside myofibrils. And there are quite a few myofibrils arranged inside the muscle fiber, which again, remember, is the muscle cell. If we remove the front of the sarcolemma and take a look inside the cell, in addition to those myofibrils, there are also nuclei, mitochondria, etc. But what's important is that it's got a specialized endoplasmic reticulum called a sarcoplasmic reticulum. That is where calcium is stored inside muscle cells. Calcium is what is needed for the muscle to contract. From the sarcolemma, the membrane dips down into the cell, forming a transverse T-tubule. So this tubule is open to the outside, which is the extracellular space, and the T-tubule is associated with the sarcoplasmic reticulum on either side. So if we take a region here, it will be like one T-tubule with the sarcoplasmic reticulum on either side, but these are actually the terminal cisterns of the sarcoplasmic reticulum. And these three together, they form a triad. In the skeletal muscle of mammals, there are two T-tubules for every sarcomere, one at every junction between an A-band and an I-band. This is the sarcotubular system, and it's important for understanding excitation-contraction coupling. Each muscle fiber is associated with a synaptic terminal from a motor neuron. The action potential that starts on the surface of the muscle membrane is ultimately going to cause this sarcomere to shorten and result in a muscle contraction using the entire system. And that is the structure of a skeletal muscle. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, give it a like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.